welcome to the Cinema Couch. We are here at BMK, and we are about to watch the documentary of You Are Not Alone. Let's go in and see the trailer.
Still in the closet about my homosexuality. I was still trying to come to grips with being gay.
Being raised in the church, that was a big, big no-no.
The good books say a marriage is between a man and a woman.
What's wrong with you? Do you need to see somebody? Do you need help?
That was the one thing that severed any relationship that we ever could have.
I was promiscuous, and I stopped counting after 100. Hey, I'm my experience, if that's what you want to call it.
I was actually a college student at 19 dealing with HIV.
If I'm going to die anyway, why am I fighting?
I just wasn't happy anymore with life or myself.
I think I was kind of forced into believing that this was just a part of life.
I guess I knew when I woke up in the hospital on a gurney, being wheeled into the emergency room after taking a handful of muscle relaxers. That was a clear sign that something was up. The problem is in your head at the moment, so you gotta talk to other people, you've gotta share what's going on inside.
You just kinda gotta get over your homophobia.
You need to pray and ask for forgiveness.
It's not as simple as that.
Because often their voices have not been heard. Your voice is part of your body. It needs to be connected to who you are.
It's who we be. I don't do black, I be black. I don't do male, I be male. I don't do gay, I be gay.
This is you, and this is how God made you, and this is, I believe, how God has made me.
Talk about that pain, being in an anti-gay and black world.
We are not meant to be inauthentic for very long.
So I don't have to be perfect being me. I just have to be me.
Well, what are you going to do on the last day of judgment? I said I'm going to say to Allah, Allah, get you a big popcorn, a giant soda, and let the video roll.
I'm here with Stanley Bennett Clay, the director of You Are Not Alone. Stanley, what inspired you to make this film?
The producer, Antoine Craigwell, told me that he was doing this project, and so he was looking for a director. So I said, well, you know, let me direct it. And so we worked out a deal, and I ended up directing it, and the thing was that it opened up a whole new world to me, because I was not, even though I am a black gay man, the thing was that I was not that familiar with all the intricacies of depression among black gay men. So it was a complete education for me, and it was an eye-opener, absolutely.
I was lucky enough to have a part in this film, and I think it's one of those things that only comes around very, very seldomly. And I think more films like this need to be made. What effect do you hope the film has in the community?
Well I'm hoping that not only the black gay community, but the black community in general, the community in general, gets a chance to actually understand the intricacies of black gay life and the isolation that so many black gay men feel, because, you know, when you're black and gay, it's certainly something that I learned through making the film, that you don't feel a part of the black community and you don't feel a part of the gay community, because the gay community on a whole is a very white sort of thing. So here you are, you're isolated from your black straight community, and you're isolated from the white gay community. So where is your place in the world? and it's like a man without a country. So that's the great lesson that I think that this film is trying to say.
Very cool. So what is the next project that you're working on?
Oh, well, right now I'm directing the stage version of B-Boy Blues, and I'm really excited about that. We just won the Audience Award at the Downtown Urban Theater Festival, and we're getting ready to go up for 3 more performances here in New York, and then we're doing the D.C. Black Theater Festival, and then from there we go on tour, and then ultimately into an off-Broadway production of it.
And you are writing a book right now?
It's my 5th novel. I have four novels that are out right now, and a novella that I wrote in an anthology, and I signed a contract to write a 5-book series called Dominican Heat. So I've turned in the first book, I finished that, then I finished the second book, so the first book is actually out. It's called Aching for It. The second book is being edited now, and I'm writing the third book, so I have 2 more books that I have to write before the end of the year.
Wow. And okay, so tell everybody where they can find your novels, and also where they can find You Are Not Alone. They want to watch it, they want to buy it. Where can they find it?
Well, right now, You Are Not Alone is still doing the circuit, the film festival circuit, to try to actually get a distributor. And hopefully, you know, the producers will be able to get a distributor to be able to get it out there to the public. And as far as my books are concerned, you can find any of my books on Amazon.com, BarnesandNoble.com. The hardcover books and the paperbacks are in various stores, and the online books, the e-books, are online and everything. And, you know, just Google my name and you know, my various books and things will come up.
Very cool. Thank you so much, Stanley, for talking to us. Thank you guys for watching.